Good morning, students. Welcome to the virtual classrooms. We are studying it alcohol, phenols and ethers. Today in the lecture we are going to study preparation of alcohols. Now when we are talking about the preparation of alcohols, we are going to have it as in, first of all, to prepare alcohols from alkenes. That means we are having it the double bond which we are going to convert it into OH. So for it we are having it as in two methods, two reactions are there. The first one, that is reacting it as in double bond with H2O in presence of H plus, right? Now when we are having it as a double bond, that means a pi bond is present in it. It gets divided into a lone pair of an electron. So both this carbon got its valency free from double bond. It got converted into single bond, and both these carbons are having free valency. At the same time, in presence of H plus, this H2O is going to dissociate into H plus and OH minus. So one of it is going to get it H plus and the other one is going to get it as OH minus, and the compound gets converted into CH single bond OH, that means into alcohol. Again, during this reaction, if we are having it as an CH2 double bond CH2, NH2O H plus is there, it's an no problem at all that whichever the carbon is going to get it H, both of them are going to have it as an identical condition. But we already know it. We have already studied it even in 11th standard as well as in the previous chapter also, Markovnikov's rule. When we are having it as an unsymmetrical carbon, that means one carbon is having one hydrogen while the other carbon is having two hydrogen, both of them are not identical, then in that case when you are going to add H2O in it, then at that time the electronegative part of it, that means the OH minus, will go to the carbon having lesser number of hydrogen atom. So in that case that becomes unfixed, that you are going to get it as an OH on second carbon. Right? If you are going to write the answer as CH3, CH2, CH2, OH, then this is going to be the wrong. Right? The reason is, according to the Markovnikov's rule, in an unsymmetrical carbon atoms, unsaturated carbon atoms, the negative group goes to the carbon having lesser number of hydrogen. Right? And the electropositive group goes to the carbon having higher number of hydrogen. So that is the one condition that we want to remember while adding NH2O H plus in unsaturated. We are going to get it what type of an OH group, second carbon, first carbon, third carbon, which carbon we are going to. That, what is the reason behind it? If someone asks why this Markovnikov rule is applied or what happens in the Markovnikov rule, then in that case, actually you can say it that when this carbon is getting converted, the secondary tertiary carbocation this is because of stability of carbocations, except because of stability of carbocations. Tertiary, first of all tertiary will get that OH, then secondary, then primary, then methyl as a carbocation, right? So that is because of it. Okay, let us see what is the mechanism that is applied behind it, how this reaction is carried out. So to see that mechanism, what we are having it is, we are having it as an C double bond C. When we are having it H2O H plus, so this H2O H plus gets converted into first of all H3O plus. What is the reason behind it? It was containing two lone pairs. So H gains that lone pair and it gets converted into H3O plus. Now that H3O plus, it reacts with we are having it as an H3O plus. That H3O plus reacts with C double bond C. During that case, what will happen? This double bond is shifted towards it. So this carbon is going to become negatively charged. Because of its negative charge, this lone pair goes to it and the H plus comes over here. This is going to become converted into H plus. So that reaction is going to get converted into CH. This carbon is becoming positively charged and we are going to get it as an oxygen with its lone pair back. This lone pair is with the oxygen. Hydrogen goes to this carbon. Carbon becomes negatively charged. So this negative charge because of this lone pair is present on it. Right? This particular step is known as, this is known as protonation of alkenes. Right? Okay. Now in the step 2, once we get it as in a protonation of it done, we are having it as in positively charged with it. So at that time, this carbon becoming a positive charge tries to attract the electron pair of the oxygen. So whole group is trying to take that pair. So at that time we are going to get it as an CHC. Now this lone pair has got reacted with it. This lone pair of oxygen is there with it. Right? So because of it, now what we can say, that this is there as an positive ion. So this reaction is known as attack on carbocation. In the step 3, now this molecule is going to react with another molecule of H2O. We got it as it's going to react with another molecule of H2O. During this case, this H plus this one is going to attack on it and we are going to get it as so during this case again the H plus is removed from it. This H plus which is removed, it's known as deprotonation. The process is known as deprotonation. So in the first step we got it as protonation, attack on carbocation and then deprotonation, and we got it as an alcohol. That's the mechanism for alkenes to alcohols by H2O H plus. That is on the basis of Markovnikov's rule. Right? Okay. We are having it as a second method also for it. The second method that we are doing it is hydroboration oxidation method. That particular process is known as hydroboration oxidation method because we are going to use it as BH3. Now particularly before we go it for the reaction, make it sure that it's a boron trihydride. many times indicated in the form of. It can be written as B2H6 also. The reason is we know that boron is having 3 electrons in its outermost orbit. So maximum 6 electrons will be there by sharing with hydrogen. It has a deficiency of electron pair. So to overcome that problem, it goes for internal forces of attraction between the BH3 and it gets dimerized. So it can be written as B2H6. It can be also written as BH3 twice. Right? Now out of these three, I'm not going to write any of it. I'm going to write it as HBH2. Will it make any difference? No. Right? It's a one in the same. So either of the way the reaction has been indicated many times, it may be asked to you as complete the given reaction. So in that case, BH3 or B2H6 or BH3 twice or HBH2, it's a one in the same thing that is written. What we are going to get it is this reaction. It's carried out with the condition for it, terminal double bond. It should be at the end only. That means either of the side of the chain of the carbon atom should contain double bond. If I'm suppose having it as in the compound in the form of this, the reaction does not proceed. For this, there is no reaction. I want the reaction, so for this case, this we are going to get it as CH3. Maybe the chain, maybe the long chain, you can have it on this side, but double bond should be on the terminal. It's reacted with BH2. Now during this case, again the Markovnikov rule will be applied on it. During this case, boron, it's being in positively charged, because we are going to get it as left to right electronegativity increases. So it's going to become positive charge. Hydrogen is going to become negatively charged. Right? This is going to become minus, this is going to become plus. So according to the Markovnikov rule, hydrogen will go to the carbon having lesser number of hydrogen. So we are going to get it as CH3CH2 double single bond CH2BH2. We get it as a boron attached on to the outer carbon. Now if one hydrogen can be replaced, we can go for the second hydrogen also to be replaced. That means if I take it as CH3CH double bond CH2 and I'm going to react it with CH3CH2CH2BH2. So during this time, this hydrogen is going to attack onto the second carbon, right? And this valence is going to become free. So these are going to get bonded with the boron. That means during the reaction, we will get it as CH3CH2CH2B CH2CH2CH3H. That means this is a compound where we got it as related to it, attached with it. Right? Now, taking it as a third time, CH3CH double bond CH2. CH3CH2CH2BH CH2CH2CH3. If I take it as a third time, then again what will happen? This hydrogen will come over here and the carbon will go and attach with the boron. So on reaction we will be getting it as CH3CH2CH2 three times boron. Right? Three times, CH3CH2CH2, CH3CH2CH2, CH3CH2. Now, this compound, CH3CH2CH2 thrice B, it's reacted with H2O2, hydrogen peroxide. So, hydrogen peroxide is going to distribute itself into OH-OH group. One OH will go and attach with the boron and one OH will go and attach with the carbon. So at that time what will happen? 3 moles of CH3CH2CH2OH plus we will get it as 3 times B OH thrice. So this compound you are going to get it as an alcohol, but the condition is always primary alcohol will be formed. In the previous reaction we saw that there is a possibility of primary, secondary, both. Here primary, secondary, tertiary, all of them. Here we will be getting it only as a primary alcohol with the compound this B OH thrice. It can be also indicated as H3BO3, that is boric acid. That's the byproduct that we are going to get with it, right? So that is the hydroboration oxidation method, right? Okay, the next one, before we go it for this was a preparation of alcohol from alkenes. Now the second preparation that we are having it, that is by reduction of aldehydes and ketones, that is reduction of carbonyl group. We are going it for reduction of carbonyl group, means we will be having it as an aldehydes as well as ketones, or even we will be having it as an carboxylic acid, right? So we will take it as, first of all, reduction of aldehydes and ketones. Now when we are talking about the reduction of aldehydes and ketones, we are going to have it as the compound in the form of CH3CHO. If it is reduction by LiAlH4, at that time what will happen? It will get converted into CH3CH2OH, primary alcohols, right? Maybe any aldehyde, it's not necessary that it's a CH3 only, it can be any aldehyde. On reduction with LiAlH4, we are always going to get it as primary alcohols. So aldehydes always will produce primary alcohols, while ketones when we are going to have it as an ketones, they are going to reduce themselves as secondary alcohols. We can have it as an any ketone, it's going to reduce as secondary alcohols fixed, right? So what does this reaction shows? Aldehydes always produces primary alcohols, while ketone produce secondary alcohols. In the similar way, when we go it for carboxylic acid, by strong reducing agent, it always converts itself into primary alcohols. Carboxylic acid always converts themselves into primary alcohols, right? We are having it as in one of the reaction for it, as in reduction. We can also take this acid into alcohol by hydrolysis, right? But before going for it, this is your second method, preparation of aldehydes and ketones from carbonyl groups, that is from aldehydes, ketones, and this one is from carboxylic acids. Okay, now we told that we can go it for the hydrolysis also. Let's see what is the hydrolysis of the carboxylic acid, the third method. In the hydrolysis of the carboxylic acid, we are having it as an COOH. We will react it first of all with any of the alcohol. We don't know what is that alcohol. So it gets converted into, we will be specifying it as an ester, because we will be producing it as ester. ROH, we get it as RCOO R dash. H2O is given out. This is reacted with H2O. It gets converted into RCH2OH, ROH. This is again in presence of Li, AlH4. Hydrolysis in presence of Li, AlH4. If it is done, then only we are going to get it as an two different alcohols. Simply writing it as an H2O, it will produce acid alcohol. But we are writing it as an Li, AlH4, that means it's going it for the reduction. So we will get it as CH2OH plus ROH, two different alcohols. Right? Fourth process, that is Grignard reaction. Reduction of aldehydes and ketones with Grignard reagent. Now, what is that Grignard reagent? RMGX. So we are having it as an R C double bond OH reacted with, let's take it as an R dash so that we can identify it. What is that R group? We will be getting it as an RCOMGX. The H is there and R dash over there, and we know that whenever we are using it about the Grignard reagent, everywhere we have studied it, it is compulsory to follow it by hydrolysis. So we are going to get it as OH H secondary alcohol. See, in the previous reaction, that was a reduction of aldehydes and ketones, we studied it over there by the reduction. What we told, aldehyde always produces secondary, but with the Grignard, aldehyde always produces secondary alcohol, right? Only and only your formaldehyde. Can produce primary alcohol. Only formaldehyde can produce primary alcohol with Grignard reagent. If I, by using any other reagents, by any other aldehydes, if I want to produce primary alcohol, then I have to go it for reduction, right? Here what will happen? I will be getting it as an R dash MGX. We will be getting it as COMGX H R dash, which on hydrolysis gets converted into CH2R. Primary alcohol, right? So formaldehyde produces primary alcohol while rest of the aldehydes produces secondary alcohol, whereas all the aldehydes on reduction produces primary alcohol. And if I'm having it as a ketone and it's reacted with RMGX, it gets converted into RCOMGX and R dash is attached to the carbon, which on following the hydrolysis, it gets converted into tertiary alcohol. So ketone on reduction produces secondary alcohol, while with the Grignard it is going to produce tertiary alcohols. Right? Now these were the reactions for the method for the preparation of alcohols. These are the few reactions that we did it. It's not necessary that these are only the methods. We are having many other methods. As already in the starting of the chapter I taught you that we will be having it as an some of the things to be studied as a preparation, some of them we will be studying it as an method for chemical properties. Right? This the portion that we are studying it at present. This is the particular reaction you are studying it as a method for preparation of primary, secondary or tertiary alcohol. In the chapter of aldehydes, ketones and carboxylic acid, we are going to have this one, same reaction, no change at all. but only the heading will be changed. In place of preparation of alcohol, it will become chemical properties of aldehydes and ketones. The same thing is going to be repeated. Similarly, many other reactions are there through which we can prepare alcohols also, right? But these are the four main methods for preparation of alcohols. Okay, the next one we are going to get, that is for the preparation of phenols. Next one we will see it as an preparation of phenols. In this also we are going to study four different methods. Number of methods are there, but out of that the four which are the main basic methods, we will be understanding it. Now, the first one, that is also known as Dow process, which we studied in the chapter number 10, one of the reaction as an electrophilic substitution reaction. Right? Particularly we know it that when we are having it as a chlorine, as an aromatic nucleus, and aqueous NaOH is added, it's becoming shorter and stronger. So we need it as a strong condition, that is 623 Kelvin temperature, 300 atmospheric pressure, a condition is required. Then only the compound we are going to get it is a OH group. Now during this reaction, when we are going it for it, what is happening during the reaction? There is an intermediate reaction that is also happening it. The chlorobenzene, it's when reacted with aqueous NaOH. Initially, it gets converted into ONa and HCl is given out. It forms an intermediate reaction. This component, ONa, in place of reacting with HCl to get converted into OH, it also reacts with chlorobenzene. This NaCl is removed out and it produces this is a byproduct. It's an useless, there is no use of diphenyl ether in the organic chemistry. It's an useless product. So this method is less utilized. At the same time, it is also told that during this reaction, once we get it as a diphenyl ether, during the preparation of it, this is added first of all. This compound is added before starting the reaction. The reason is, according to the rules, Lee-Chatelier principle, this component is already produced. So no more component will be produced for this. And as a result, we can get it as a maximum product for the phenols, right? So starting of the reaction, diphenyl ether is added, but that is not an actual condition. That what will happen, we are going to get it as somewhat loss as a byproduct. So this method is less utilized. This is the one of the method that is less utilized, right? Okay, second method, through benzene sulfonic acid. That is, we are having it as an SO3H group present on the benzene ring with solid NaOH. It gets converted into phenol. Right? Whatever the number of SO3H groups are present, suppose if you are having it as an SO3H group, not only present on the first position, it is also present on the third position, then we can say that we get it as resorcinol. It's an OH group, phenolic OH group that is prepared. So SO3H with solid NaOH gets converted into OH. The third method, through using benzene diazonium chloride salt, that is already used it in St. Mayer reaction, N2Cl. Actually, we wrote it as N double bond NCl. This we write it as N2Cl. So when this N2Cl is reacted with H2O. On heating it, it gets converted into phenol. So benzene diazolium chloride can also be converted into phenol. The fourth method that we are having it, particularly it's named as cumene process. We are going to term it as cumene process. This is going to be the most important process. Why? When we are taking it as an CH3, the compound, two CH3 groups, when it's reacted with O2 in presence of 5% Ne2CO3, we get it as CH3 are there. It produces cumene hydroperoxide. The compound produces cumene hydroperoxide. This compound, on acidification, it produces phenol plus acetone. Now, it's an useful byproduct. This time, we are getting it as an useful byproduct. So, we are having it as an, this as a most important industrial method, industrial process for preparation of phenol. Right? So, there can be a question for you that why in place of Dow process, cumene process is more used as an industrial process. You can say that during the Dow process, we get it as a byproduct, which is useless. No use of it, and so we get it as an hardly 80% of the yield, whereas for the cumene process we get it as an 100% of the yield with useful byproducts, right? So this process is more useful than that of the Dow process. Okay, we studied it related to preparation of alcohols and phenols. In our next lecture we will study related to the chemical, physical and chemical properties of alcohols and phenols. Right? Till then, thank you.